Hello friends, today in this tutorial I will be telling you that how to make a Wikipedia viewer kind of application. So in this application you will be able to serve any sort of Wikipedia page inside your application, JavaScript application. So this is a simple input field. Here you can just, this is a search engine. You can type here the name of the person to which you need to search for Wikipedia, and as you type here you will see, as you type, the results will come here at the bottom, and you can just select. You can see these much of results are there, and as you type here it will constantly update these results. So you can see now if you want to click this result, you can right click it, open a new tab, and it will open this Wikipedia page, detailed page, where you can just read more detail about the person inside the Wikipedia official website. So in this way we can quickly search for a person on Wikipedia. This is a Wikipedia viewer kind of a application in HTML, CSS. We have styled this also using CSS, and then we are making requests to Wikipedia using JavaScript in background. So you can see as you make, write something here, and again if you click it, you will see it will open this inside a new tab. So you can see if you just delete it, all the things will be gone here like this. So I will be showing you how to do this inside JavaScript. So for all the source code, you can just go to the video description. I have given the link in the video description. So this is my step-by-step blog post. So in this way, you can just build a Wikipedia page viewer search engine in browser. So this will be vanilla JavaScript. So just go to this video description link, the blog post, and then now let me just guide you how to create this from scratch. So I will delete all the code here and tell you step by step. So now as you can see, this is my text editor. You can use any text editor of your choice. I'm using Visual Studio Code text editor. So the very first thing you need to do is that you need to create index.html file. This will contain the bare bone HTML code. Simply go to the blog post and here inside index.html, copy to clipboard all the source code and simply paste it. So let me just brief you. We are using some Bootstrap also, you can see, for the styling purpose. So we are including the CDN, and then this is the bare bone HTML. We have a simple form element. Then there is an input field where we can enter the name of the person, and then we have a simple button of search. And also we are including some jQuery as well, guys. So we are including the CDN of jQuery. Now we need to make a second file which will hold all the style sheet code, style.css. Make this file, and now if you drag down you will find this code, copy to clipboard, and simply you need to paste this code. That's it. Now we can include this file also, so by the link tag here. So we have the link tag inside our HTML. So we can give the URL, which is style.css href attribute. So now if you just open this with live server, you will see the styling part will be complete here. You will see it is successfully styled. But if I type here, nothing will happen because we need to also bring the JavaScript as well. So the JavaScript file will be there. This is script.js. Simply copy to clipboard and make an additional file here which will hold the JavaScript code, script.js. Paste this code here. That's it. And now we can simply include this file after we include jQuery. So simply make a script tag and include your file script.js. That's it. And also close the script tag. And now if you refresh it, your application, you will see. Now if you type anything here, let's suppose HA, now the results will come here. As you type here, you will see if I click any of the results here, the Wikipedia page opens of that person. So you can read more about that person inside this window. So this is the one application. The second application I wanted to convey, this is the second blog post. So basically, with this application, you will be able to generate a random Wikipedia page article of a person. So every time you click the button, it will generate a random article on Wikipedia. So let me just show you the screenshot of this. So you can see this is a screenshot. If you click this button, it will generate the random Wikipedia article. All the source code is given in the video description. I have given two blog post link. This is the second blog post link. So simply copy this. You can just copy this code inside index.html. And now if you see here, this will change. Now we also need to grab the CSS as well. So if you just go to this part here, just copy the CSS code as well. So also for this also we are using some Bootstrap, so we are including the CDN of Bootstrap. Copy paste the style sheet code, and now you can see if I refresh our, it will be styled here. You will see Wikipedia viewer. And thirdly, what we want to do is that we need to grab the JavaScript as well. So this is a JavaScript, so simply copy this code and simply you can paste it right here. Paste this code, and now your application is complete. If you click this random article button, you will see it will open a new window on Wikipedia, and every time if you click it, it will generate a random article. So you can see this is random article 1. If I again click this random article button, it will again return a unique or random Wikipedia page. So every time you hit it, it will create a random page. And also you can also search for this article as well. So you can search the name and by little animation, it will give you the person articles here. You can see if you click it, it will open this inside new tab. So in this way, we can build a simple Wikipedia viewer inside browser using vanilla JavaScript and jQuery and some Bootstrap. All the two blog post links will be there inside the video description. You can just download all the source code, just copy to clipboard. And thanks very much guys for watching this video. Please also check out my website freemediatools.com. This is a tool based website where almost 180 tools are there related to audio, image and video. So please also share this website with your friends, and I will be seeing you in the next video.